When I think about trucking, I think about the sticky black sludge on my windowsill, and I think about the constant cough I would have at night because the freeway emissions are coming into my house. So thinking about what's the best way to reduce the impact of trucking is really what's on my mind.
Trucks generate over 41% of the greenhouse gas emissions out of the entire transportation sector. That's really a unique perspective because trucks are a much smaller population of vehicles than passenger cars. But because they operate diesel engines and because they're operating anywhere from 8 to 20 hours a day, they are much more impactful. So we realize if we want to fix the emission solution, we need to focus on the most disproportionate contributors to greenhouse gas emissions. And that's what we've done. You've seen an immense growth in the amount of last mile delivery vehicles that are operating on the roads today. And that's really the segment that we're focused on.
This is what a fuel tank looks like in the age of electric vehicles. This holds somewhere between 45 and 90 miles of range. We use somewhere between 1,600 and 3,500 of these per battery box. They get loaded over here into what we call clips. Once that's done, we mount 24 of those clips, 12 on each side, and turn it into a battery module. By being modular, by having the ability to add or remove battery from the vehicle, even after delivery to the customer, we're able to adapt to their changing routes and needs without having to pre-purchase all of that capability on day one and then be stuck with it. It looks just like your truck because it is your truck. We've taken the body that you normally use to do all your business with and we'll put it on our chassis. This is an electric vehicle. You can get road dirt, but you don't get a lot of the other kinds of oils and grimes that you find on a conventional diesel. We're proud of this machine. Let's go for a drive.
Los Angeles is actually one of the worst air quality zones in the country. It's because of the distribution centers and the large population of diesel trucks. What a lot of folks don't realize, they're disproportionately affecting communities of color that ultimately don't have a choice as to whether they get to live near these industrial centers or near these diesel trucks.
Black and brown people didn't wake up one day and they were like, you know what I really want to do? I want to live next to a freeway. I want to live next to a port. I want to live next to a trucking facility. If you were restricted by the government from getting home loans in areas that are more environmentally healthy, where else do you end up but adjacent to these types of land uses that are going to create asthma and other health detriments to you? Climate tech companies can do good while doing well. The technologies that they're creating are mitigating climate change, and they can grow with communities. So I think something that's always on our mind is, how are we gonna get our companies to create good green jobs, where you can, one, recruit from the community that you're in, train people or upskill people for those positions, and most of all, make sure that you're hiring them and offering them benefits. Thank you.
What everybody can do, from a driver to a fleet manager to regulators, is get educated. Understand the technology that exists today and how we can actually make these transitions. And the more educated we are, the more informed decisions we can make, and ultimately make this zero emissions future a reality sooner.